Salutations, Eric and Dom are moving this tree to get repotted and restyled. Here's Chris helping Eric move the tree onto the table. This tree is called a Texas Cedar Elm. In 2013, Eric, with the assistance of Mike Lane, collected this cedar elm. Follow us on Instagram and you will see more of these photos with information. Hurricane Ian damaged this tree quite a bit. The tree lost a branch and was tilted forward in the pot. I'll show you further in the video. And here we go. Using that sickle to loosen the tree from the pot. Along with this beautiful morning light, you can see that the tree is tilted forward and we will be making it upright. Now it's time to take the tree out of the pot and into a new one. Dom is taking out all the leftover mesh that was from inside the pot. The mesh pieces were basically engulfed by the roots, so Dom had to end up using a root hook in order to get all of them out. Because the tree was tilted forward, one side of the root ball has to be smaller than the other side in order to make it straight and upright again, as it should be. There was a top piece of deadwood that ended up becoming soft inside, so he just went ahead and ripped it off. Just like that. Taking out any crumbs of the dried out softwood. Here I'm trying to show you a little bit better of what I meant by one side being a bit smaller than the other side of that. And then the deadwood pieces. Now it's time to do some root pruning. It's almost like hairs. Time to rinse any loose soil or roots. Now we're getting ready for the new pot. Again, we use our coarse soil for a majority of the trees in our nursery. Because one side of the root ball was shorter than the other side, there has to be a hill within the soil, so this way it would be able to stand upright versus tilted forward. And you can see here how it's slanted, and that is because of the hill of soil inside that pot, and it's straight. Eric uses charcoal in the soil for his deciduous trees because it has purifying properties. This will prevent any issues for these trees when they go dormant in the winter time, if they're staying too wet. Now it's time to add fertilizer. Now it's topped off, and we can clean the trunk. Remember to thoroughly rinse out the soil if you are using vinegar to clean the trunk of your tree, making some changes to the deadwood here. Satisfying. This part of the tree ended up becoming softwood anyways. Eric is inserting a screw into the trunk so that he can lower this branch here. The lower branch that broke in the hurricane caused Eric to rework the design and lower the first branch to balance the tree and make the left side of the silhouette shorter. You can see the branch gradually getting lower as he tightens the wire. Eric will intertwine the wires to make it look a lot neater versus having two strands separate. Eric is cutting this branch to balance the silhouette of the tree. See there? This tree is large enough for us to simultaneously work on it, applying lime sulfur to redefine the deadwood. Eric is anchoring down a branch, as you see there. Found another little air plant, so it's time to transport this little baby in one piece this time. Boom. And here we are with the final rinse. Since this tree was so big, this is our version of a turntable. Myself and Chris are holding the backdrop. Looking beautiful. Come check it out at Weigert's Bonsai. Follow us on all social media platforms. Audio Jungle.